I am someone who travels extensively. This time I thought I should make a little video on what you should actually take along with you when you're traveling. You could have nausea, you could have loosies, have stomach aches, you could have headaches, you might catch a fever or a cold, you might have your joint pains, you might feel excessively cold depending on where you are. You might be in the beach in that case, whatever. Discuss with your doctors, but I'm going to share what I do. And I have lupus nephritis. I've been battling for the past 6 years. So I can assure to you that there are things you can do to actually live a close to normal life. What basis do you book a place? Like what is the accommodation? I'm staying here. On what basis do you book the accommodation? And how do you know what to book? What are the basic amenities in that place that you should be looking for? Right, so I'm going to walk and shoot this. Okay, forgive me if there's ambient noise and lack of clarity, but the view is beautiful. Okay, so we're going to start with basics. Okay, in my case, I have acute gastritis, ulcerations in my stomach, erosions and whatnot. So antacid, anti-nausea, anti-acid reflux. These are the three things that I would carry. That is a Domstal or an MSET, etc. And if you have a stomach pain, higher Cmax or Cyclopam, please do not buy these medicines without asking a doctor. For God's sake, understand the genre classification of medicine that you're supposed to carry and speak to your doctor. Speak to your doctor. Open your trap and speak to your doctor. Now that we are done with the stomach and below, like a urinary tract infection, like I mentioned in the past. So if you are generically prone to catching urinary tract infections, you should firstly buy a stand and pee, okay? There is a stand and pee option that is offered by Pee Safe, where you can literally just stand and pee. That's one. Make sure you're carrying Citra Alka syrup and plenty of water, and prone to getting acidity, acid reflux, then these citrus fruits is something you should take only towards the afternoon of your day, so that you don't get, you know, acid reflux and stuff like that, acidity. That's another one. So with respect to pains, it depends on what pain medication your doctor has prescribed to you and what you're allowed to have. Few of you may have liver toxicity, then few of you may have allergy to some painkillers, you may not be allowed. So make sure you please ask the doctor. For the nth time, I'm telling you, I am no doctor, I'm just a poor little patient. So in my case, I'm given a set of pain medication which I'm not going to focus on. I don't want to focus on those set of pain medication that I'm given, because that can cause damage to a lot of people. So yeah, pain medication for leg pains, headaches, I guess generic pains, that's all I can think of. And if you have fibromyalgia, make sure you pack your fibromyalgia medication. For example, I have fibromyalgia, so night sleeping can get a little tough with restless leg and just a nagging pain in my legs. Everywhere else I'm kind of fine. It's mainly my limbs, hands and legs. That's the thing. Last but the most important, your lupus medication. Do not skip your medication for God's sake and your sake and your family's sake and your loved one's sake. Do not miss your medication ever. So if you're on chloroquine, steroid, you know, immunosuppressive drugs, whatever the hell your doctor has given you, your multivitamins, your whatever, I'm just going to be swinging. So whatever your doctor has given you, take them, pack them, consume them in the right time. No bullshit. Food is very important. Make sure when you're traveling, you do not eat anything that's oily. Cut oil to the maximum. So I have really good steamed food options. You know, you can have a good healthy sabji that is not having a lot of oil in it, preferably that. You know what, just comment telling me like what are the bloody options that are healthy. You know, this pre-cooked food is not something I would recommend. So make sure you pack food that stayed from your house, or don't be choosy. Okay, now enjoy the view with me. Just feel the mountains with me. First phases in lupus will also heal, I can assure you. I am the living proof. I had the worst complications. If you haven't heard my story, you can actually see it. Side effects. I've had multiple surgeries, multiple invasive procedures, multiple investigative procedures, biopsies, lumbar punctures, whatnot. And today, here I am. So make sure you plan wise and travel wise, and make sure you live a good life. Lupus will not stop you.